Imagine making videos 3 days in a row about Evander Kane. Yeah, I guess this is kind of the territory we're in now on the channel, because Evander Kane has been probably the biggest name in the NHL community the past few days. With the contract termination, to the grievance, to the free agency, it's all been such a big, big story with Evander Kane, and now we have ourselves some teams that apparently might have more interest in this winger than others. So, let's just go over the little scoop. We did indeed have Kane's contract terminated, I guess, by the San Jose Sharks. Now, there will be grievances filed by the NHLPA and the agent Dan Milstein, so we'll see where that goes. But because Evander Kane is no longer property of the San Jose Sharks, he is a free agent, meaning that any team could go out there and sign him, should they wish. Now, we did have ourselves a few words from NHL insiders indicating however many teams went out there and asked about Evander Kane. Rick Dhaliwal earlier today on Donnie and Dolly said, I believe it was like 10-plus teams went out there and have contacted the agent about this player. But the team we're focusing on in today's video is one that I don't even really think this was on my radar. You know, I have my bingo card served up for 2022. I didn't think that this team would do any of the things that they're doing right now. And we're talking about the Edmonton Oilers. So, Edmonton, as we have highlighted in several videos in the past week and a bit, they've been a bad team. They haven't been scoring at 5-on-5. When McDavid and Draisaitl are not on the ice, they're not getting any offense. They can't get any scoring from the rest of their lines that don't have McDavid and Draisaitl. Their goaltending has been subpar. And now the coaching staff is under flame. We're debating as to whether or not they're going to stick around, whether or not their futures in Edmonton are guaranteed beyond the next few weeks. And it's been really, really bad. Yeah, they're kind of falling out of the playoffs now. LA, San Jose, Vancouver, these teams are right there on the tail of the Oilers. And we'll see whether or not any of these teams are actually able to break in and take over the final spot for the Pacific and the wild cards and all that. But when it comes to the Oilers, depth scoring has indeed been one of the many issues that has plagued this roster. Now, in my opinion, depth scoring isn't really like the biggest thing they need to worry about. I have like two more priorities in my personal hierarchy of Oilers needs that I think need addressing first. One is goaltending. Second is coaching, because yeah, okay, goaltending, if you don't get goaltending, you can't win any hockey games. Secondly, the coaching, because even with McDavid and Draisaitl on the ice, this team 5v5 is still abysmally bad, and these guys are still below average when it comes to 5v5 goal differentials. So even if you have two of the best players in the NHL, you still are not a good 5-on-5 team. Your 5-on-5 strategies involve the same thing. Try to get the pass up to McDavid, try to spring him up for a breakaway and make sure he scores every time, because McDavid is probably one of the best players on the rush to have ever played the game, so you obviously want to go out there and utilize that strength. It's just kind of bad when that strength is the only strength you have and everybody else can't really get involved. And when you don't have the puck and McDavid isn't on the rush, it's laughable how bad the Oilers are at creating offense. But when it comes to the depth forward scoring issue, that indeed is another problem they have to work with. It is not the one I think is the most important. However, according to Ken Holland, it appears that, they might actually be focusing more on that depth scoring issue rather than any of the other issues we had highlighted in the past 2 minutes here. Let's talk about the Oilers and Evander Kane, because it came out in the media yesterday. It was Pierre LeBrun on That's Hockey on TSN. He said, talking about teams that have kicked the tires on Evander Kane, the Oilers, for example, I know, are one of those teams that have kicked tires. Does that translate into a bona fide contract offer? Well, I can't tell you that. Then, later on, earlier today, we had ourselves follow up. There was a media availability done by Ken Holland. Let's go over the quotes over here that he had talking about Evander Kane. He says that he has indeed talked to Evander Kane's agent, Dan Milstein. Now, he does go out there and preface this by saying, yeah, I know Dan Milstein very well because he was Pavel Datsyuk's agent. And because, you know, I was with the Red Wings, I talked to him a lot, so I know him very well, which is why I talked to him about Evander in this situation. There were a few other quotes here. Let's go over onto an article on CBC.ca. The other quotes going over here, he says, when asked about Evander Kane, who is now a free agent and able to sign with any team, he says that he wouldn't turn down any player in a similar situation before getting an understanding of what's going on. I believe in second chances, Ken Holland said. It's hard to be perfect. We're all people. We all make mistakes. Now, I saw a lot of people memeing this quote and saying, okay, what the heck, dude? Like, second chances? We already talked about this a few days ago. This is not second chances right here. This is like third, fourth chances right here. How many chances is enough chances before you're going out there and saying, okay, darn, like, is there really a need to go out there and try this? In Winnipeg, there was the entire thing with Buffalo in the tracksuit. Obviously, in San Jose, his teammates didn't want him to be there anymore. There's all the off-ice stuff as well. I don't know where you're hearing second chances, Ken Holland, but I mean, I guess Ken Holland's gonna Ken Holland, right? He does say this, some people make big mistakes, some make little mistakes, but it's hard to be perfect. Going over onto the other quotes that he had here, he said, as a GM, it is my responsibility to investigate every situation, and I have indeed talked to Dan. The rest of the quotes over here go over how if somebody makes a decision or does something to change in their life, they make a mistake, I think they have to try and learn from it and try to change, and then they should be entitled to a second opportunity once they do some of those things. Now, I'll just go out there and say it right here. I do think, based off of this, that we're probably going to see a contract. And I'm making this video specifically because it was actually Rick Dhaliwal earlier today on the Donnie and Dolly show who said that Kane wants to go to a contender, and maybe, in some retrospective analysis of the league, maybe Kane would go out there and say, hey, Edmonton, not really a definite bona fide contender right now because they're in a slump. Maybe if I go over there, I play in the middle six, I help them out with their depth scoring, maybe they become a contender. Then, Evander Kane wants to go to a contender, and based off of how Ken Holland is talking about this guy, like, you cannot tell me that there isn't any interest anymore. Ken Holland, as the GM of the Edmonton Oilers, you know, a great storied franchise that's got two of the best players in the world, one of the best in Draisaitl, and the absolute best in Connor McDavid, there's no way he'd go out there in the media and talk about Kane to this extent and keep on hammering that point down. Yeah, second chances. He deserves a second chance. He's not perfect. Nobody's perfect. Because he's not perfect, that means we gotta forgive him. We gotta give him the opportunity to redeem himself. Second chances, second chances. He would not go to that extent to defend this guy and talk highly about this guy if there was not some very bubbling interest, you know? It's a witch's cauldron over here of interest just bubbling and ready to burst out the seams. It seems like the Oilers really, really want this guy. And I don't know how to feel about that because, you know, I'm a Canucks fan. It's easy for me to go out there and say, oh, good players? I don't want the Oilers to get good players. And you know what? Kane, good player. We've said this the entire time in all the videos discussing Evander Kane. He is a very talented player. And I did say in the video talking about Kane and his trade list, which apparently included Florida, Tampa Bay, and Vancouver, that I feel like if Evander Kane does go to a contender, like he goes to a team that is already on the up and up and that already has a pretty good established profile of successful hockey players on them, I feel like once Kane is onto a team that is that good, like a Tampa Bay or a Florida, it's no longer about the crap that is surrounding this guy and that has surrounded this guy for years already. It's no longer about his teammates not liking him. It's no longer about his gambling issues. It's no longer about his debt. It's no longer about him faking his vaccination status. It's no longer about him disobeying the team and going out on his own without the team's permission and medical clearance. It's no longer about him betting on his own games. It's about playing. It's about playing hockey on a good team and thriving with guys that could actually go out there and win. That's kind of how I feel Evander Kane and his mindset might navigate a new team that happens to be good. I did say that. That's a perspective that I do think probably would hold itself accountable should he go to a good team, but like, it doesn't erase any of that. You know, yes, second chances, third chances, fourth chances, whatever. This stuff still happened. This stuff was still controversial, and it still does have a stain on Kane and the way he is perceived by the public. Does that need to affect him? Under the guise of being a navigation tool to explore change? Yes. However, we have very much clearly seen that Evander Kane has so many issues that I don't really know if it's possible to think that these kinds of things are going to be redeemed anytime soon. But at the very least, this might be some form of a peace of mind kind of thing, you know? Okay, forget about the outside world. I'm focused on playing hockey. I'm focused on scoring 30 goals or whatever. And I'm going to do that playing behind Connor McDavid and Draisaitl because the Oilers need depth scoring more than they ever had before. So, I don't know if there's going to be a contract. If I had to guess, I'd say probably yeah. But, you know, anything can happen, right? Talk to me in the comments. What do you think about Evander Kane and the very apparent interest the Oilers have in him and his services? I hope you enjoyed this Vitra Trolls 99. And bye.